There were three new items introduced into Pokemon Unite with the mobile update. Those include the Choice Specs, the Razor Claw, and the Weakness Policy. And we're going to go over all three of them, exactly how they work, and Pokemon you should think about putting them on, okay? So let's start here with the Choice Specs on Gardevoir. The way they work is they take a percentage of the Pokemon's special attack, and they add that as bonus damage whenever they use a skill, along with a little bit of extra damage on top. So at level 1, the Choice Specs take 30%, plus an extra 40 damage. At level 10, they take 35% plus 50 damage. And at level 20, they take 40% plus 60 damage. Okay? This will work on any skill. So I have Moonblast here, I have Future Sight, and I have the Unite move. All three of these are going to get the exact same amount of bonus damage because it goes off of my special attack value, not off of the ratios on the skills themselves. Hey, somebody followed. Hey, thanks for following. Editing swing point here, I want to clarify a couple things. I said all skills, I meant all skills that do damage, so if you use Barrier on Mr. Mime, it's not going to go ahead and make the bonus damage show up. Also, in an area of effect situation, I believe what we're currently thinking is that if two Pokemon are hit at the same time, it's only going to work on one of them, and the theory is that it's the closest Pokemon to you, but don't really know quite yet. Go ahead and look at the comments, and if we get that figured out, I'll let you know. And something to help make this really easy for you guys to figure out is this Unite DB resource. So these guys have already calculated all the different special attack values on these Pokemon. So in the case of Gardevoir here, if you go to level 15, which is where I'm at in game, level 15, she has 1001 special attack. Now, in the case of the Choice Glasses here at level 20, I also get plus 29 special attack due to the passive of the Choice Glasses. So my value here is actually 1,030. And you can do this for any Pokemon. In fact, you can go to the stats up here and then just click special attack. And you can organize it by who has the most special attack. So these Pokemon here are going to get the biggest number whenever they use the Choice Glasses. So this is where things get really interesting because Venusaur doesn't have great ratios on their skills, which made the Wise Glasses kind of weird on them. Same with Pikachu. But then Venusaur has a really high special attack, and Pikachu has a really high special attack, meaning that you're going to get a nice big chunk of damage whenever you use the Choice Glasses. Okay? So let me go ahead and show you exactly what that is. So if we have 40% being taken off of 1030, plus an extra 60 damage on top, what that should result in is if we use our skills here, we should get an extra bonus 472 damage. So let's go ahead and take a look. Moonblast, if you pay real close attention, we can even probably slow it down here for you. You'll see an extra number show up in there and it says 472. Now, one big thing you really got to keep in mind with the Choice Specs though is there's an 8-second cooldown in between this damage bonus. So if I use Future Sight and you see that extra 472, but then I use Future Sight again, you see how it doesn't show up that time? So you have to wait 8 seconds in between these. But you can also note that it's always going to be 472 bonus damage for Gardevoir here. Now, if I go ahead and I use the Unite move, you'll see a little 472 kick in right at the beginning. And now this is where we start talking about item synergies. We're finally at the point where things can look really cool from that perspective. So if you use the Wise Glasses comboed up with the Choice Specs, that's going to make your Choice Specs a lot more powerful because you're adding straight to the base value of Gardevoir's special attack. So if you have an extra 5% onto your special attack, that 1001 turns into a 1051, basically, which would make it so that the Choice Specs have a higher value to work off of. There is one more thing I want you to keep in mind when looking at their special attack values. If you go ahead and take a look at Ninetales here, and then also Pikachu, they end up at about the same spot, but they have a very different journey to get there. So if you take a look at Pikachu here and take a look at his special attack, it starts at 50, and it ends at 954, and it climbs at a pretty regular interval. Now that's very different from Ninetales here, because take a look at level 4 and level 3, alright? 117, 156. Now keep in mind that Ninetales evolves at level 4. And what you'll see with Ninetales is there's a big power spike from level 3 to level 4. So the scaling gets a little bit different. They end up in the same place just about, but Ninetales gets a little bit more use out of it in these mid-levels compared to Pikachu. Now onto the Razor Claw. The Razor Claw is pretty similar to the Choice Glasses in the fact that it uses bonus damage. And so the way the Razor Claw works is whenever you use an ability, your next basic attack is going to have bonus damage added to it. Well, how much bonus damage? It depends on what level it is. So at level 1, it's going to take 40% of your physical attack and then also add an extra 10 damage. At level 10, it's going to take 45% and then just add 15 damage. And then at level 20, it's going to take 50% and then add 20 damage. So in the case of my Talonflame here, I have level 2 Razor Claw. So I actually get plus 1 attack. And then Talonflame here, with this most recent patch, has 681 attack power. Add that plus one, so we have 682. So if you go ahead and take 682, and then multiply it by 0.4 to represent the 40%, and then add 10, because that's what the item does, you'll get 282 extra damage. So let's see if it adds up. Use an attack, and then ba-bam. And you'll see, oh, I attacked twice, which is actually a really good point to bring up. There is a cooldown. But either way, you see the 282 extra damage from the move damage. Move damage means it's the item. There is a cooldown with this item, but it's not like the choice specs. It seems like the cooldown is somewhere in between 1 and 2 seconds. So in the case of Talonflame here, when you use that big combo, you'll probably get to take advantage of it at least a couple of times. So if you go Brave Bird, and then Aerial Ace, and then attack, and then Aerial Ace, and attack, I wouldn't be surprised if we slow this down, if I manage to get the Razor Claw to work twice. Now, one more thing to keep in mind with the Razor Claw. Razor Claw also causes a slow if a melee Pokemon is using it. So I'll try to showcase that here. I'm going to attack him to get him started. I'm going to use a skill, and then I'm going to attack him again so you can see the Razor Claw slow him down. So attack, and then Flame Charge, and then attack again, and you'll see he gets slowed down for a little bit. One last thing to keep in mind with the Razor Claw is that after you use an ability, you don't have forever to go ahead and use it. So if I were to fly right here, hit the ground, and then not attack for a little bit, I'd say after about a second or two, you're going to lose the ability to get that move damage in. So make sure you're pretty quick with when you use it, and then you'll get that extra little combo damage in. And then you can do the same thing with physical attack as you did with special attack on Unite DB. If you go and organize by attack here, you'll see which Pokemon have the highest attack, and then they will do the most damage with the Razor Claw. But again, keep in mind with the Razor Claw, it comes after you use a skill. So that's why I was using Talonflame, because they have a big combo where they use their skill and then they basic attack. They use their skill and then they basic attack. So play your Pokemon. If that works well with that Pokemon, then the Razor Claw might be a good choice. And now onto the weakness policy. The way the weakness policy works is if you take damage, you get more attack power. It stacks up to 4 times and it has different percentages per tier. So at level 1, it's 2% per stack. At level 10, it's 2.5% per stack. And at level 20, it's 3% per stack. Okay? And it's 4 stacks. So if I go and hit these bees over here, I'm pretty sure Snorlax does about 291 damage to a bee. Let's see. Sure enough. And then he actually double attacked there, and you got to see the effect kick in already. Now, again, it stacks up to 4 times, and my weakness policy is level 1, so I'll get an extra 8% damage once I have all 4 stacks maxed out, because it's 2% per stack. Meaning, I should do 314 damage here. Sure enough. And I'm pretty sure the weakness policy cools off after like 2 seconds. So I bet you if I go and hit them again, yeah, I'm not even at my 314 anymore. So you're really gonna have to judge your playstyle on this one to see if it makes sense for you. Again, you need to take damage for it to work, and that damage doesn't last very long, so you need to kind of keep taking damage in order to keep your buff up. So it's up to you. Go ahead and decide whether or not that's worthwhile. And one thing I really want to mention to you guys, in case you did not already know, is make sure you take a look at your events, because on the topic of items here, held item enhancement support missions are here, so you get a lot of item enhancers from that. Also, way more importantly, the super held items. So if you reach trainer level 10, trainer level 12, and trainer level 14, you can get a super item enhancer for each level. And what that does is it takes your item and it throws it all the way up to level 30, just like that. No big deal. So I actually went ahead and used one of those already on my scope lens, and my scope lens was already level 20. But what's nice is if you use it on the item that's already level 20, or really whatever level, it'll refund the item enhancers that you used to get that item up to that level. So I used a super item enhancer on my scope lens, and I got like 500 something item enhancers back because I already had it at level 20. And then I went ahead and used those to make my choice specs go up to level 20. So use those items wisely. You're only getting 3 of them for now. But in case you're wondering how good an item could be at level 30, and I don't want to use my super held item enhancement, well, there's this max grade trial campaign. So if you go ahead and accomplish the things that are within this event, you can actually go and claim one of these. And this does the same thing where it upgrades an item to level 30, but it only lasts for 7 days. So if you want to see how it works, see how it feels, these are a really good option to do that with. A lot of things changed with this mobile release update. These items are what I wanted to cover today. We'll be covering different stat changes and patch notes stuff later. We stream just about every single night on twitch.tv/swingpoint, where we do viewer games, so I'd love to see you guys over there. Link will be in the description for that. And also, we have a whole channel dedicated to Pokemon Unite. If you're already watching over there, thank you so much for being there. But if you're on Swingpoint, go ahead and check it out. It's a whole channel dedicated to just Pokemon Unite stuff, and we'll be doing exclusive Pokemon Unite stuff over there pretty soon. We just started like 2 weeks ago, and it's been doing great. If you get over there now, you'll be one of the first ones there. You'll get bragging rights. So, thank you so much for being here. You guys are awesome, and I'll see you in the next video that we do around here.